In this video, we'll talk about escape sequences in Java. And so I'll create a little program here. Public class, you're never gonna guess. Escape sequence fun. This is all subliminal messages. By the way, you really ought to thank me. Last night I was recording these last couple videos, and I had gotten to the point I recorded a bunch of videos, and I was very grumpy, extremely grumpy. And so I was recording those videos, and I thought, no, I'm not going to record these videos. I'm too grumpy. I'm going to wait, come back in the morning when I'm feeling happier, and so I won't be grumpy in my videos. So you can thank me later. Also, I messed up, and so I had to stop, and I was forced to stop. So that's beside the point. Okay, so public static void main string args. Okay, so we've got, let's say we want to print something out, system.out println, and I'm going to print something like these, like when we want to be kind of sarcastic, I'm going to do some air quotes. I'm going to say, I really love these videos. And I want to put the love in quotes. And so, I really love these videos. And I'm going to put the love in quotes. Well, we run into a problem, as you can see. If I try and run this, I'm going to get an error saying I expected a parenthesis. I thought we were done here because you closed this and we didn't concatenate anything. The quote means something to Java, right? It means I'm starting a string or ending a string. So how do I print this out? If I actually want to print quotes inside my string, how do I do that? Well, Java gives us kind of a neat little way of doing it, and that is it creates these what are referred to as escape sequences, and we access an escape sequence by doing the backslash. And so we say backslash quote, and what that tells Java is whenever it sees a backslash, don't print this, interpret this. So the backslash is kind of a special character where it means whatever comes next is going to tell you what to do. And so in this case, a backslash quote means print a quote. And so if I want to print another quote, I need to do another backslash quote. And now, if I run this, I really love these videos. I forgot my punctuation again. I really love these videos. That's done in quotes now. Now, for those of you that are naturally smart, you're saying, well, wait a second, what if you want to print a backslash? Well, that's a good point. If I was trying to print backslashes around the word love, it's going to yell at me and say, you can't do that. Backslash L doesn't mean anything. Backslash space doesn't mean anything. Okay, so how do I print a backslash? Well, the escape sequence to print a backslash is backslash backslash and backslash backslash. So I've got two backslashes on each side. I really love these videos, and now I've printed it. I had two there, but it's only printing one because the first one is telling Java do something instead of print something, and then the second one is saying here's what I want you to do, and in this case I want you to insert a backslash into the text, if that makes sense. So, and by the way, just someone told me this a while back, how do you tell the difference between a backslash and a forward slash? Well, if you look at them, you've got a backslash and you've got a forward slash. The backslash is falling back. The forward slash is falling forward. If you look at like a person standing on their feet, this one's falling back. This one's falling forward. And that's how we tell the difference. So backslash, backslash will print out a backslash. Well, what else can we do with these escape characters? We can go back to our quotes. I really love these videos. How about if I want to print on a couple of different lines, system.out.println? Now, first of all, we haven't done anything with the print versus print line. If I print something like 1 here, and then I come down and system.out.print, again, not print line, but print. Then it prints both of those words on the same line. A print prints and it leaves the cursor wherever the printing was stopped. And so when I go in and print the 2, it's just going to print it there. And if I printed a 3, where's it going to go? Well, because I did a print on the previous line, the cursor's still sitting in the same place, and so it's going to print on the same line. So the print line, print ln, makes it so it prints and then it goes down to the next line. So now I'll see it print down on a few different lines. 1, 2, 3. Okay, that was kind of a little side note. But if I want to print on 2 lines, I could just do 2 print statements. But Java gives this the ability to say something like, I want the next text, and then I want it to drop down to the next line and say to go on the next line. Well, right now it's all going to print on 1 line. So what do I do? Well, Java gives us the ability to put an escape sequence to go into the next line. So I can say backslash n is the new line. So I can say backslash n, and that will take us to the new line. I want the next text, new line, to go on the next line. Okay? Period. I'm as bad as the students. Okay, so I want the next text to go on the next line. What other escape characters do we have? Well, there's a backslash T, that's the tab. You can print a single quote using the backslash. So this one's the tab. We hit that spot and then we tab over to the next tab stop. That's helpful for lining stuff up in columns when we're trying to do it that way, or whenever we need a tab in the program. So there's a few different escape characters and they go right in the middle of the text. Notice we don't break out of the text to print them. It goes right in the middle of the text, and then it's executed because it sees that backslash and knows that it needs to do something as a result. In this case, there's no T printed out, it actually does a tab. All right, so that's escape sequences. Easy enough, not so easy to say. Spencer out.